Welcome back to part three of my Canva series, where I'm walking you through how to use Canva as a business owner. If you haven't seen the first two parts, make sure you've seen those too. Today we're gonna go through your business branding kit, how to set it up, what is even in it, and then how to use it when you are editing content. If you're new to my channel, my name is Megan and I help business owners go from confused to confident on social media. So what is the business branding kit on Canva? Basically, it's a part of Canva where you can store all of your business branding materials and be able to easily access it when you go to edit. It saves time and it's really easy to use. Keep in mind that this is a pro feature of Canva, so if this is something that you are really wanting to use, you will have to be paying for Canva. I've said it before and I'll say it again, I am a big fan of Canva. It's so user-friendly and saves me so much time, and I definitely think it's worth paying for the pro membership, but you definitely don't need to in order to get started on the app. The branding of your business is so important because first impressions are everything. People are going to decide whether they like or don't like their business from the first time they see you. So your branding is a big reflection of who you are and what you stand for. I always recommend choosing colors, themes, and aesthetics that really speak about who you are as a person and a business owner. You're going to be using this brand to attract clients that you want to work with, so you want to think of it as something to be specific about and part of your marketing plan as a whole. If you already have your branding figured out, then great, you're ready to go. And if not, then you can use this video to help you start branding your business and put it all into Canva so it's organized in one place. So for example, my business branding color is green. And if you haven't chosen a brand color, I definitely recommend looking through what each color really means to people and the underlying feelings or thoughts that they get when they see these colors. You will see a lot of big brands out there using this color psychology to their advantage. So keep all this in mind when you're creating your content. Now let's hop onto Canva. We are in the branding section of Canva, and I'm going to walk you through my brand kit so I can show you everything that's in there. First is logos. I recommend uploading every variation you have. Then some colors. Put as many as you need here. I have quite a few. And then you want to go through some fonts. These are just some of my most commonly used, so you don't have to pick too many specific ones. You can pick two or three. Next, there's this really cool thing called brand voice. And this is if you want to use the AI feature of Canva where it helps you write out some of your content. If you put in any descriptive words about your brand here, I put relatable, approachable, and professional, it will actually change that text to sound more like these descriptive words. Next, I recommend uploading photos of yourself. These can be branding photos, nothing crazy here. And then some graphics if you have them as well. At the bottom, you can also do icons, but I didn't put anything for that. So you'll see them all listed on the left here, and it's stored underneath the brand section. So now if we're editing an actual graphic, what we do is press the brand button on the side, and it will show you everything we just put in. So this is really nice because your colors are all here, your logos are all here, your text. So what I'm going to do is actually change the colors to my brand colors, which are nicely put on the side for me. And I'll just choose the colors that I think work best with this graphic. Same thing for the images. You're just going to select what you want to replace and go to your brand images. Just drag and drop those. I like how simple and easy this is to have everything in one spot on the left over here, so I don't have to go searching through all of my uploads just to find, you know, a logo or a good picture of me. So once you like the way it looks, you can go ahead and change the text to your fonts. So again, that's going to be on the left underneath fonts. You'll just look for your business name and everything will be underneath that. Once you feel like all of the text looks good here, then you are good to go. And now you have a branded graphic with your own colors, your own photos, and your own fonts. Something else you can do that's really cool is if you go and search for a specific brand color palette that you want to start using, you can download that from the internet or Pinterest or wherever you want to, add it to Canva, and place it on the graphic that you're using.
Then, once it's there, you will right-click it and go all the way to the bottom where it says Apply Colors to Page. As you can see, it changed every color on the page, but if you don't like that, you can always do it again and it will reshuffle the way the colors are on the page. So you're just going to do this until you like the way it looks, and you can do this for all of your graphics. It's so easy to change the colors this way.
I'm so glad you stayed with me through that Canva tutorial. I love having my business branding kit in there, and I know you will too. If you're still not sure who you're trying to reach on social media and who your ideal client is, I have the perfect worksheet for you linked below. It's completely free, so make sure you give that a look after this video. And of course, I want to know in the comments what else you want to learn on Canva or social media in general. Don't forget to like this video if it was helpful, and then watch this video next to see the difference between hashtags and keywords on Instagram and how it'll affect your business. Thank you so much, guys. I will see you in the next video.